We pick up this morning now in chapter 6, and for our study this morning, I've divided this chapter in just three sections. So Paul is speaking from first-hand experience, standing upon the standing in front of that judgment seat, and he's telling you believers, you are taking your disputes out in the open, in front of an unbelieving judge, and imagine what shame it's bringing to the name of Jesus Christ. Does that mean, you know, Paul is saying we should disregard civil courts and legal authority? Not at all. In fact, in his other writings, in Romans 13, verses 3 to 4, Paul says that, you know, the courts and the people whom God has put in governmental authority, they are actually appointed by God and they should be honored. So what he was really addressing is the real issue here is brother against brother. Then there is a problem amongst ourselves, between brother to brother. How do we resolve it? What should we do? What Paul is basically saying is resolve it internally within the church. Get somebody to sit down. Get somebody to address this problem. Such were some of you. This was your past. But you have been washed, you have been sanctified, and you have been justified. In the name of our Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God. Can you imagine living in that filth, and now you've been brought out, you've been made completely clean, and now what was once filthy, depraved, sinful, corrupt, today is holy, it's consecrated, it's set apart for God. He says, that's who you are. So when you see people who are living in that kind of a situation, when you see somebody bound in homosexuality or any kind of sexual sin or any other kind of immoral, wrong kind of lifestyle, you look at them with eyes of hope. Look at them saying, my God, in the name of Jesus, this man, this woman can be washed, sanctified, and justified. That's how you and I should see them. Do you get that? The Lord is for the body. Your body is for the Lord. So the first truth that's going to help you and me stay from away from sexual sin. First, my body is for the Lord. This body is a part of the body of Christ. That means Jesus Christ is going to be revealed through this body. So what Paul is saying is, look, I've said all this. Your body is for the Lord. Your body is a member of Christ. You are spiritually one with Jesus. In the light of all that I've said, your only response to immorality is for you to run from it. So keep in mind that sex outside of marriage, it might appear exciting, but it's never enriching. It is only enslaving, destructive, troubling. So see, in this whole passage, verses 12 to 20, Paul is presenting truth to these believers who've come out of a very depraved background and who are actually living in the middle of a society. And he's saying, look, live by these truths. And that's how for you and me as believers today, we have to live by these truths. Right? We can't let the world around us control us. No. We live by the truth of the Word of God.